Yazine is also up amongst the leaders as they come to that water jump again.
You know, they all look a little too comfortable. Nobody's struggling to stay up. It's hard to know what the pace is in the steeplechase because depending on where the water jump is, the laps are different. But I think the Kenyans are letting this go too slowly.
All right, we'll be back with the conclusion of the 3,000-meter steeplechase right after this. 3,000-meter steeplechase final continues. They're approaching the water jump once again, and the Kenyans are running 1-2. Bernard Barmasai in front. Ruben Koske, also known as Cerrone, is in second place. Ali Azin of Morocco is third. Inside him, Luis Miguel Martin of Spain, then Wilson Boyd Kipketer of Kenya. They've got just over three laps to go.
The Kenyans have tried to pick up the pace, and they've knocked about half of the field back, but they still got a big group. The longer the athletes can hang with the Kenyans, the more chance they might have to outkick them at the end of the race, because basically the Kenyans have run faster times than anybody in the race except Rahim Boulami. And if they just run up to their potential, no one should be around them. So they're playing with fire here by not working together and trying to push the pace.
Barmasai the leader, but now Koske goes up, his Kenyan teammates. And Ali Azin, the Moroccan, is on the outside in third. Martin, the Spaniard, hangs with them. As Kipketer, the third Kenyan, joins the chase.
Well, their laps now are about 5 seconds faster than they were the first two laps, so the pace has picked up a bit. I think Azin up there in their peripheral vision and, you know, in second place now should shake things up.
Azin continues to push the pace. Koske, then Azin, then Barmasai, then Wilson Boyd Kipketer. The new entrant amongst the leaders is Günther Wittelinger of Austria in the red. Martin of Spain still hanging there along the inside.
Well, what seems to be a minor theme in this Olympic Games is upsets in the in some of the races where the athletes got used to competing on the big European circuit where they had pace setters and guys that go out and lead for half of the race and then drop out of the race. When it comes down to a race like this that's tactical, it opens the door for a lot more people. It's not a time trial anymore. It becomes a race of tactics. It becomes a race of acceleration and surprise.
Koske of Kenya still the leader, coming to the water jump again. Koske of Kenya is in front. A couple of Spaniards have now joined the leaders, and the Kenyans are still very much in evidence. Ali Azin of Morocco still there within striking distance.
This is incredible. There's never been an Olympic final where there are this many men. There's probably nine guys with one lap to go who have a chance to win the race.
And here's the final lap, and now the racing begins in earnest. Koske trying to hold on to the lead, and three Kenyans are in front.
This is incredible. There's going to be so much traffic over the hurdles. It could be possible that someone will go down.
Koske leads. Wilson Boyd Kipketer second. Barmasai third. Ali Azin. Here comes Martin of Spain. He's also up there.
He's also a big surprise. The Kenyans just didn't do what you expected them to do, which would be to run everyone off their feet. They've opened this up. It's a crapshoot right now.
Martin of Spain hanging with the Kenyans. Here comes the kick. Through the home straightaway, and the Kenyans running 1-2-3 over the final hurdle. And it's a sprint to the finish. And it will be Koske that beats Wilson Boyd Kipketer. Azin gets bronze.
Well, shut my mouth. They just said, we're not listening to you. We can win this any way we want. Slow, fast, but they didn't get the sweep. I think Boulami or Azin got in there for third place. And in Kenya, that will be considered not a total success. And look at the final straightaway. The Kenyans did have a kick, The Spaniard faded badly in the last 50. The race for the gold medal. Some pushing there. Now, how can the Kenyans can't? I don't know if they can file a protest against each other. There were a lot of pushing.
Well, the Kenyans run 1-2 in the 3,000-meter steeplechase. In the closest finish ever in the Olympic 3,000-meter steeplechase, Ruben Koske beats his Kenyan teammate Wilson Boyd Kipketer, with Ali Azin of Morocco taking the bronze medal. So the Kenyans continue to dominate this event with three of the top four finishers, including the gold medal winner, 21-year-old Ruben Koske.
Let's tie up